Hello, I'm Sangeeta Ram, Technical Marketing Engineer for Valor NPI. The ODB ++ Viewer is a great tool for reviewing the contents of the ODB ++ manufacturing file. It gives you a chance to make sure your design intentions are correctly represented and to see what the board manufacturers will be using for the analysis, programming, and setup of their equipment. An ODB ++ is actually a manufacturing CAD database. ODB ++ is often compressed into a single file for sharing, with a TGZ file being the most popular and native format to the tool. Other compressed file types are recognized, such as ZIP, TAR, Z, and GZ. Typically, you will import a TGZ for viewing, and the tool will automatically uncompress the file for use in the same directory. To view your file, start up the ODB ++ Viewer software and the Jobs List dialog will appear for opening the project. If you are revisiting a project, simply select it from the list and choose Open. Otherwise, select Import Job to view a new project. With a new dialog open, we can select the ODB ++ input file and choose to either open the uncompressed database by selecting its folder using the Accept Directory button or select a compressed directory such as .tgz and choose Open as we will do here. If the populated default does not meet your needs, you may specify a new file path or job name. A confirmation dialog of the file to be imported will appear, and often you may be asked to overwrite a directory if there is a conflict. With your file loaded, we can see the profile of the board in the graphic area, and on the left we can see the manufacturing layers that make up the design. Organized by colors, we start with the topside components package layer, followed by the silk screen, solder paste, and solder mask. The copper layers will vary slightly in color depending on whether it is a signal layer or a plain layer. Followed by the drill files, D1 to 10 represents drills penetrating from layer 1 to 10. Some additional blind and buried drill layers are also found in this design. Supporting document layers will follow below, such as drill charts, drawings, and notes. Selecting a layer will enable its visibility in the graphic window, and its color assignment will be chosen by the order in which you select the layer. The default setting for selection 1 is red, 2 is green, 3 is blue, and 4 is yellow. The default colors can be modified using the View Color Settings option. Multiple layers can be switched on at a time and a maximum of 25 colors can be used. Navigating the graphic window can be done using the various options like zoom in, zoom out, zoom area and pop view, etc. You can also use some common keyboard actions such as page up for zoom in, page down for zoom out, and arrow keys to pan around the board. Use home key to zoom all. The mentor mouse strokes also work in the graphic window, such as zoom in, zoom out, zoom area, and zoom all. If you click in the middle mouse button in the window, it'll pan in the direction of your mouse pointer. The overview window with the red filled box will help us to understand the area of the board that we are viewing in the graphic area. We can also use the zoom area command to quickly navigate to an area of the board, turning on different layers and reviewing feature properties can be useful in understanding the design. To see a feature attribute, enable the highlight command and select a feature and open the View Properties dialog box. Many of these properties can also be found along the bottom edge of the screen. Please note, the intelligent ODB++ file will provide many of the same features found in the actual PCB layout, such as its assigned net name and whether the feature is an SMD pad, a toprint or a VR or something alike. Using the measurement utility can be useful for determining gaps and feature sizes found in the design. Distance can be measured between features on different layers too. Measure between points, you can measure from any point to any point. You can also use the measure annular ring to determine the annular ring of the pad. You can also measure between nets by selecting two different nets. Also, taking advantage of your right-click menu will offer some quick shortcuts to your most popular operations such as zoom area, pop view, measure, highlight, and to clear highlighted features. Please note, in order to select a feature, you must enable the highlight feature command, which can be found by using the right-click menu, or it can also be found in the icons toolbar. There is also a highlight to icon for allowing you to select a different feature at the same time. Also remember to use clear highlighted when you wish to deselect any highlighted features. If you enable the component filter icon, a new window will appear below the ODB++ layer list. Selecting the RefTest from the drop-down list and pressing the result arrow will quickly zoom into the vicinity of the component. By picking different radio buttons, you can search according to different component properties available on the ODB++. Although this covers the majority of what you need to know, let's take a look at some other features found in the tool. A toggle units button will make sure that you see the units that you understand. And looking under the View pull-down menu, some user preference settings can be made. Use the color setting dialog for customizing your display colors. And using the component options will allow you to alter which component properties are to be displayed, such as pin numbers and pin 1 indication, net names and part numbers. You can also modify the font size and the text overflow for readability. Moving on to the actions pull-down menu, we have the board orientation, which allows you to rotate or mirror the board. And finally, a highlight net and highlight net option allows for reviewing specific nets found in the design. If you double click a particular net in the design, by double clicking on the net in the highlight card nets window, it will quickly highlight the entire net and all related copper in the design. Note the indicators that appear next to each layer where the routed net can be found. It's always good practice to review the contents of your design output files prior to delivering. So make sure ODB++ Viewer is part of your everyday toolkit.